Hey, what's up guys, welcome back, you're watching Prototech. Infinity X is one of the top contender in the list of highly customizable ROM. We already reviewed almost all builds of this ROM where we discussed each and every details of this build. All Infinity X ROM videos are available in video description. Last time we reviewed its version Infinity X 3.0, you can find its link in iCard video. But few days ago, team have rolled out its version 3.1 for all official devices. An amazing developer doze made available its custom JSA version for all Android devices. So we flashed this build, and today in this video we are going to review its device details, all new changes as per changelog, and at the last I shown which bugs are still persisting this ROM. So make sure to watch this video until the end. Now without further delay, let's get started. I booted this build on my oneplus 9RT using doze loader. Any device can test this ROM without removing your primary stock ROM. Please check doze installation tutorial video given in iCard, and its link is also available in description. Let's check out the new changes of about device details of this ROM. Here you can see this is the Infinity X official version 3.1. It's a treble droid Android 16 build. Maintainer of this ROM is doze. Security patches are updated to the latest 1st August 2025. This is major part of the changelog. In the quick setting panel, build number is mentioned as A16BP28050620250031. So this ROM is now synchronized with the QPR2 source code of Android 16. Now we will check out all the new changes one by one. I will not discuss all the features of this ROM. For detailed review, please check our Infinity X 3.0 video given in a video description. In treble application, now we get the OT updates. This is very useful feature, so whenever we get updates, you will get the notification of updates in the OTA. Like here I got the new update notification because immediately after release of this build, which you are reviewing in this video, team released the new build with minor fixes one day before. Here you will get the details of your current ROM version and update version details and its size. You can download and install update, or you can also get manual update option here, which redirects you to the file manager so you can choose your desired JSA package which you already downloaded. But remember, don't use this if you are using this ROM via doze loader. It will not work with doze, but it's working with the ROMs which are flashed with fastboot method. Next, in the same treble setting application under display option, we got new Windows blur setting. Here you get the three different blur effects, Gaussian, Kawase and Kawase 2. But Gaussian blur effect looks very nice and gives glass-like effect to QS panel. This blur effect only working for QS panel. Next, team have done great improvement for performance of the ROM. Actually, Infinity X already well optimized the ROM and it's very fluid. But this time team have improved the touch sampling rate and it can reach up to 240 Hz. But your device must have support for 240 Hz or above touch sampling rate. Here my 9RT has 600 touch sampling rate, but when I tested it using a touch sampling rate testing application, it given me 125 Hz of maximum constant touch sampling rate, which is not bad. Next, default lineage or aperture camera application now supports 100x zoom. If your device have support for such insane zoom, 100x zoom will work in aperture camera application. Next, in the recents panel for long press menu, team have added lock and unlock options. This helps to lock applications in the memory. So even if you clear all recents application, locked application will remain in the memory until we unlock them from memory. Next, for long press menu of app drawer and home screen icons, we get free form mode to open supported applications into multi-window. As per changelog, overlay has been updated for some devices like S22 Ultra, Tecno Spark 8 Pro and Redmi Note 13G. Except these changes, some fixes has been done for real, so some devices may get working 4G LTE calling by default. ROM is extremely good, but still it has some bugs. The new bug I got in this ROM is no 4G network working at all. You have to rely on 2G calling. But on 2G network, internet is not working. But you can use internet via Wi-Fi if you want. This is very annoying. In the last build, we got working LTE network and internet. Only 2G calling bug was there. Devices with the left side camera punch hole cutout may get status bar misalignment like old build. It can be partially solved by using punch hole cutout option available in the display cutout of developer setting. Google circle to search is not working even though I enabled its toggle available in the navigation button option. But you can follow our iCard video and can use circle to search in any ROM. Under display fingerprint is not working like old build, but you can use face unlock as alternative for this issue. Next, app sidebar is not working. It's not showing any applications even though I added lots of user application via sidebar setting. It only shows the app drawer and browser application when you open sidebar by swiping over sidebar pill. So these are all the bugs and issues I got in this update. The bug of no internet is a deal breaking for me, except that we have alternatives for other bugs that I mentioned earlier. Remember, custom ROM users will not get any kind of these issues because of dedicated development by InfiniTex team for their devices. Not all customization features are available in the InfiniTex suite, but they will be available gradually in upcoming updates. ROM still can be considered as one of the best Android 16 ROM following Rising OS. This is all about for today, guys. Hope you liked our work. Then please do like and share this video. Subscribe to our channel. Press the bell icon for notifications of such amazing ROM reviews and Android mods with tutorials. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Take care. Bye bye.